मेजर श्रीराम हमारे यूनिट में जब पोस्टिंग आए थे तो काफ़ी यंग थे वो, तो उनके साथ काम करने का हमें मौका मिला.
मेजर डी श्रीराम ही इज़ फ्रॉम आर्टिलरी एंड ही वाज़ अ शॉर्ट सर्विस ऑफिसर एंड कमीशन इन 2004. ही केम टू दिस बटालियन इन 2007, जस्ट अबाउट यू कैन से 3 or 3.5 ईयर्स ऑफ सर्विस. And he was located at a post called Chingmairong. That was the time when this unit was in Mantri Pokhri and responsible for almost the complete Imphal Valley. And that was the time he carried out a lot of operations. And it's a number of operations, not just one operation. And about KCP and PULF, at that point of time, the valley was heavily infested with this kind of, there were a lot of unrest. Lot of unrest, and the scenario was much different from what you have got right now. There was a lot of setbacks to security forces in number of, we had a lot of security forces personnel have been ambushed and everything. But the best part of Sriram had been that under him, not a single casualty was there in the unit. He had such huge caches, eliminating 12 hardcore militants, 23 apprehensions, huge recovery arms, but not a single guy or not a single casualty to the unit. I think that is one of his best achievements. So we can say his all the operations were very specific end based. He had built that kind of network in this valley, which was giving him, you can say, effective operations. He went, he suffered no casualty, not to him, not to his men, and there was no collateral damage as well. That's the best part of it.
Today, the center and school conducts recruit training as also in-service training for the trained soldiers. On an average, we train around 1,000 to 1,200 recruits every year, as also we carry out CI and jungle warfare training for around 10,000 to 12,000 trained soldiers of the force every year. Training is important to hone up his individual and collective skills, as also to absorb the technological advancements. It is because of the good training that has been imparted here at the center that the force has performed exceedingly well in operations, be it during counterinsurgency operations or during the conventional operations in the past.
Assam Rifles training is definitely different from army training. There are reasons for this. I will not be incorrect if I say Assam Rifles is army plus additional responsibilities of border management and say ops. As of today, we have 46 battalions. Out of 46 Assam Rifles battalions, 15 battalions are in border guarding role and 31 battalions are in counter-insurgency roles. Keeping this thing into mind, the training at training center has been structured in such a way that the recruits who pass out from here, they are proficient in the primary role, which is the SIOPS, border management, and also equally proficient in the secondary role, which is the conventional ops, that is fighting alongside the army whenever the time is there. Most of the Assam Rifles battalions are in SIOPS, counter-insurgency operations. There are numerous occasions when you are operating, you come across women, you come across children. A need is felt that there should be lady police, there should be Mahila police with them and all that. Balanced battalions which in border guarding, there is free move regime. Border is porous. There also border outposts are there. There also a need was felt that how to check, how to frisk women who are crisscrossing the border and all that. So this was a challenge which was the Assam Rifles was facing for so many years. Finally, the solution came when this induction of Mahila soldiers was allowed to the force. So it was seen as a solution. Mahilas came, they were trained, they have entered the arena of battalions. But they are operating alongside the men, the same operations. If that be so, the training was to be same. The training curriculum, the training period, their tests and the benchmarks, everything is same. There's no difference in the training.
AR soldiers, the dilemma that face. Now you see, they are from this place only, most of them. They are actually sons of the soil. And if you actually go back into the families, you will find some of their relatives may be in some of the groups as well. So it's a very difficult proposition for them as well. They suffer from this dilemma, and they suffer from, you know, the security concerns as well. Especially when you got this tribal culture, tribal society over here. So often they are caught in this dilemma, ki ghar jaake main kya batau? Ghar jaake main kya batau? This is a dilemma they often face. But let me assure you, finest soldiers, Assam Rifle has got the finest soldiers. And the history goes back about 186 years old. Yes, there are numerous successful operations which Assam Rifle has been carrying out. And Northeast, the peace, whatever you see in Northeast, you can give much of the credit to Assam Rifles, because they have been here since 186 years old, and they've been here only.
Jain sahab.
Sir, CEO sahab ka phone call tha. Aap se urgent baat karna chahte hai.
Theek hai sahab.
Jain sir, Major Sriram this side sir. Sir, 0.550 sir. Sure sir. Sure sir. It will be done sir.
He had a huge success, like he eliminated 12 hardcore underground cadres of various groups. Around he apprehended 23 underground cadres and huge haul of weapons. And you can see it was all because he had an excellent internet work over here. And it is surprising that a guy who had never been to Northeast of India and who generally belongs to the southern part of this country came here, jailed around with the people, with the local populace, and had gained their confidence that they were coming up to him voluntarily to give him intelligence and everything. And it was a huge impact on insurgency at that point of time. And these two groups, especially KCP and PULF, which were actually rendered redundant by his operations. And today PULF is, you can say it's all over. It's, although it's in ceasefire with us, but it's over. They have laid down their arms and they have surrendered to Indian Army, Manipur State Government, and similar is the case with KCP as well. So you can say Sriram had a huge role to play in this. And because of his operation, the number of operations he carried out, the unit also did extremely well at that point of time. And the unit was honored, was awarded the unit citation. And unit was just that point of time, it was you can say just about 3.5-4 years old itself. The unit was raised in 2003 and 2007 he came, and 2008 we got this thing.
Inter network to unka itna behtareen tha ki ilake mein us samay jo Imphal mein mere khayal se jitne bhi inter agencies operate kar rahe honge tamam logon se unka liaison tha, bahut badhiya liaison. जो भी छोटी मोटी इंफॉर्मेशन होती थी शायद वो लेते थे और हमारे कमांडेंट साहब को बताते थे. तो हम भी सोचते थे काफ़ी यंग अफसर हैं, उतना अनुभव नहीं होगा इनको. लेकिन हमारा जो ख्याल था एकदम विपरीत निकला. मेजर श्रीराम बहुत ही अनुभवी, ऐसा लगता था जैसे कि वो सीआई इलाके में पहले ऑपरेट कर चुके हैं, पहले यहाँ पर रह के जा चुके हैं, हर चीज़ का ज्ञान था उनको.
हम सिंगमेरंग पोस्ट में था. सिंगमेरंग पोस्ट में हमारा कंपनी कमांडर है मेजर श्रीराम, ये उसके साथ मैं बद्दी था. हमेशा उसके साथ हम ऑपरेशन करता रहता था, दिन रात उसके साथ ऑपरेशन किया. तो हमने 10-11 ऑपरेशन किया था, हर ऑपरेशन में कामयाब मिला था. हम श्रीराम साहब के साथ हम काम करके बहुत अच्छा लगा था, क्योंकि उसने अच्छा गाइडलाइन किया था.
हमें लगता था मेजर श्रीराम पहले से काफ़ी मेच्योर्ड है. जब हम उनके साथ में मूव करते थे कहीं भी तो बहुत बढ़िया गाइड करते थे,